So in the last lecture, you learned about property binding. So we put a property between square brackets and then bind it to a field or a property in our TypeScript class. Now let me show you another example. This time I'm going to create a table. Inside this table, we're going to have a row and one column, like this. Now, this time I want to bind this call span property to, let's say, call span field in our class. And then I'm going to set this to 2. Save. Now back in the browser, we got a blank page, which means something is not right. So let's take a look at the console. Once again, the shortcut is Shift Command and I on Mac and Shift Control I on Windows. All right, look at the error. Can't bind to call span since it isn't a known property of TD. What's going on here? Well, in order for you to understand this error, first you need to understand the difference between DOM or Document Object Model and HTML. DOM is a model of objects that represents the structure of a document. It's essentially a tree of objects in memory. HTML, on the other hand, is a markup language that we use to represent DOM in text. So when your browser parses an HTML document, it creates a tree of objects in memory that we refer to as the DOM. Now, we can also create this tree of objects programmatically using vanilla JavaScript. So we don't necessarily need HTML, but using HTML is far simpler. Now, here is the key thing you need to know. Most of the attributes of HTML elements have a one-to-one mapping to properties of DOM objects. There are, however, a few exceptions. For example, we have HTML attributes that don't have a representation in the DOM. Here, call span is an example of that. So when we parse this HTML markup and create an actual DOM object for this TD, that DOM object does not have a property called call span, and that's why we get this error. So call span isn't a known property of TD. Also, we have properties in DOM that do not have a representation in HTML. For example, earlier I showed you that we can bind to the text content property of H1. This is a property of a DOM object, and in HTML, we don't have such an attribute. Now, when using property binding, you should remember that you're actually binding to a property of a DOM object and not an attribute of an HTML element. Once again, in 99% of the cases, these HTML attributes and DOM properties have a one-to-one mapping, but we have a few exceptions here and there. So here we're dealing with the call span attribute. If you want to bind this attribute of the TD element, you need a slightly different syntax. So in square brackets, you need to prefix this attribute with ATTR, which is short for attribute, and then dot. This way, we're telling Angular that we're targeting the call span attribute of an HTML element, in this case, TD. Back in the browser, we don't have any more errors.